Okay, hi. So till now videos we will see about the what are the different types of the notches and what are the different types of the weirs. In from now onwards we will see what are the discharge equations for each and every type of the notches and solving some problems on them. So let's go into the first one, that is the discharge over the rectangular notch or rectangular weir. Let's draw the diagram of this rectangular notch. From the side view it is looking like this. So if this is the water, there will be a water flowing over like this. These all are the water. So whatever this layer of water passing over the top of the crust, we already said it is called as the nappy. And whatever this portion, top portion will be there, it is called as the crust. And this is the liquid surface. So now I am deriving discharge equation for this rectangular weir. So for that I am considering the rectangular shape. This is the rectangular shape, whatever this rectangular weir or notch will be there, this is, and this is having a length of L. And in this rectangular weir, to derive the discharge equation, first of all I am considering a small strip. This strip having a thickness of dH. So why I am considering small strip means it is very complex to derive the discharge equation for entire notch at a time. That's why for all the weirs and notches, first of all we are considering very small strip, and later onwards we are integrating that strip. Whatever the discharge equation came for this strip, we are integrating over the entire dimensions of the notch. Then we get the entire discharge equation for the total rectangular weir. So this is the small strip I am considering. So this is having a length L and the thickness dH. So what is the area of this rectangular strip becomes? It is nothing but the length into thickness, that is L into dH. That is area of strip equal to L into dH. And we already know the discharge equation is nothing but discharge Q equal to how we came means multiplying the area of the particular section with velocity. That means area of the strip with velocity. So what is the velocity? Velocity is nothing but V equal to root 2gh. We already know this equation. This is nothing but the Torsellis equation, V equal to root 2gh. We already derived from the when we are discussing about the orifices and mouthpieces there itself. So now we are deriving the discharge for this strip. That is nothing but discharge for rectangular strip equal to area multiplies by velocity. That equal to what is the area? L multiplies by dH. And what is the velocity? Root 2gh. But before going to into the discharge equation, we are calculating actual discharge. That means we have to take the actual area and actual velocity. But what is the formula for this one? It is the velocity equation for theoretical velocity, not for the actual velocity. If we want to get the actual velocity from the theoretical velocity, we have to multiply the coefficient. So this is the discharge equation. That's why we are multiplying the discharge coefficient, that is CD. This is why we are multiplying CD, means we are finding out the actual discharge. But whatever will be there, here we are getting the theoretical discharge. That's why we have to multiply with the coefficient, then we get the actual discharge. So now this is the discharge equation for this small strip. Now we have to derive the discharge equation for this entire rectangular weir. So what we have to do, we have to integrate the this equation with the dimensions of the rectangular weir, that is from 0 to total head capital H. That is that equal to discharge Q equal to integral of 0 to h cd l dh root 2gh. With respect to what we are integrating means, that is the dh. So that is what happens, integral of 0 to h cd l root 2gh with respect to dh. I am writing here. And in this equation, CD is constant. It is not related to DH parameter. And length also constant. And root 2G also constant. Whatever the constants will be there, I am taking out those parameters. Then it will become integral. Then it will become CD L root 2G. And what is the remaining terms? Integral of 0 to H. What is the term we are left with inside means? That is root H with DH. Root H with DH. So, CD L root 2G. It is nothing but the H power 1 by 2. So, what is the integral for the H power 1 by 2? It is H power 1 by 2 integral equal to h power 1 by 2 plus 1 by 1 by 2 plus 1. That equal to h power 3 by 2 by 3 by 2. So h power 3 by 2 by 3 by 2 with what limits? 0 to h. I am taking this 3 by 2 to the outside, then it becomes 2 by 3. 2 by 3. CD L root 2G. By substituting the parameters, it becomes H power 3 by 2 minus 0 power 3 by 2 always becomes 0. So ultimately the discharge equation for the rectangular notch or rectangular wear is nothing but Q equal to 2/3 CD L root 2G H power 3 by 2. What are the parameters? Here Q is nothing but the discharge in terms of meter cube per second. And 2/3 is a constant. CD is nothing but the coefficient of discharge. And that coefficient will be given to you. And L is nothing but the length of the rectangular wear. Whatever will be the length will be there. And G is nothing but the acceleration due to gravity. And next, whatever the H will be there. H is nothing but the total head of water. If this is the rectangular wear, what is the head of water will be there? That is called as the H. So this is the discharge equation for rectangular notch or rectangular wear without having velocity approach. If velocity approach will be given in the problem, then we have to calculate the or taken the velocity approach value also. That is plus HA power 3 by 2 will be there. That is H plus HA power 3 by 2 will be there. The derivation we will see in the next classes. This is the discharge equation without velocity approach. And for this derivation, we will say solve a problem based upon the rectangular notch or rectangular wear. Okay, let's see the problem on the discharge for the rectangular notch or rectangular wear. Now we already derived the derivation and this is the problem they given. So what read means? A rectangular notch 2 meter wide has a constant head of 500 mm. Find the discharge over the notch if coefficient of discharge CD equal to 0.62. So first of all, write down the whatever the data they given. They given first CD is equal to 0.62 and they given rectangular notch having 2 meters wide. That means length is equal to 2 meters they given and has a constant head of. Head is represented with capital H. H equal to 500 mm. That means in terms of meters, 500 by 1000, that equal to 0.5 meters. They ask us to find out the discharge. So what is the discharge formula for the rectangular notch or rectangular wear is Q equal to 2/3 of CD L root 2G H power 3 by 2. This is the equation we already derived. So let's substituting one by one. 2/3 CD value is nothing but 0.62 and length they given as 2 meters and root 2 into G value as 9.81 and H value as 0.5 meters, so 0.5 whole power 3 by 2. So by solving this we got a value of 1.294 meter cube per second. The discharge is measured in terms of the meter cube per second. So this is how we find out the discharge from the rectangular notch or rectangular wear by using these parameters. If we know the dimensions of the rectangular wear or notch, and what is the head over the notch, what is the head flowing over the rectangular notch or rectangular wear, and then what is that coefficient of discharge. So if we know these parameters, we can easily find out at wherever the channel or for whatever the channel, for whatever the section, we can calculate the discharge coming over from the, that notch.